And welcome back, fellow adventurers, to Let's Play Dreamfall Chapters. We've just been speaking with, I guess, Zoe Shrink, I'm assuming, Dr. Roman. And we'll probably spend a little bit more time talking to him, but for now, let's just have a look around his office.
I see. No, I really shouldn't. It's a trap. A psychological trap.
Looks like animated Rorschach tests.
Is that a dragon? Well, it looks like a dragon. What does that mean? What does that say about me? That I'm, into dragons? Dragons are cool.
I agree. Although there may be more to it than that, since dragons do play a role in this story.
I could stare at that for hours, and then I really would go insane.
Yeah, maybe. Books.
Exactly what you'd expect a psychologist to keep on his office shelf. No tawdry romance novels, fantasy, or science fiction, unfortunately. Books on shrink stuff. Shrinky books. Exactly what you'd expect a psychologist to keep on his office shelf. No tawdry romance novels, fantasy, or... Exactly what you'd expect a psychologist to keep on his office shelf. If I drink more of that awful synthetic coffee at this point, I'll really need therapy. If I drink more of that awful synthetic coffee at this point, I'll really need therapy.
Synthetic coffee, hmm? Doesn't sound as enjoyable. No comments on the knickknacks over here? Or the computer screens? Hey, Zoe's on there, although I guess that's to be expected.
That's my file. I feel an almost irresistible urge to peek.
Do it.
But I shan't. It's never a good idea to read what your therapist writes about you.
You know you want to.
Oh, hell, just a glance can't hurt, right?
Go for it.
That's my file. I feel an almost irresistible urge to peek.
Oh, maybe we have to do the use command.
Nope, nothing at all. A bunch of personal information I had to fill in for my first appointment. And now I feel really guilty for peeking. Boo. I don't know what I was hoping for. A she's real cute note in the margins?
Hollow sculpture.
I didn't know the doc was into cephalopods. I wonder if he has a pet one at home. I always wanted a pet cephalopod. They're the best.
Doesn't look like an octopus. Some other sea tentacled thing.
I didn't know the doc was into cephalopods. I wonder if he has a pet one at home.
Okay, I think that's all that we can see in the room. We have a nice view outside, even though it's kind of raining.
I could stare out this window for hours, but the doc will probably get really annoyed. Seshadri Tower has the best view in Propass, bar none. Ah, I can see our house from here. Oh no, not our house at all.
All right, so let's have a look at Zoe's journal, and we can see what she's been up to since she woke up from the coma. Then we'll have maybe we'll have a look through the character library as well. So Tuesday, April 4th. This should be the same year, I think. So 2220. Awake, alive, amnesiac. Doctor told me to keep a journal. Said it might help me deal with not remembering, because this might be temporary. But it might also be permanent. A whole year lost. So, journal. Dictating. Voice to text. Expect some rambling. How to begin? Hello, diary? Hello, dear reader of my diary? No, I'm the only one who could be reading. I made sure of this. All the encryptions. And I'm certain I'll never read this because awkward. No matter. This is about the process of recording my thoughts. My days, my life. The days of my life. This is about remembering. So, key points. Been awake for a few days now. Still in bed most of the time, but drugs and implants and robotic appendages are helping make this a rapid recovery. A rapid physical recovery. Getting used to food. Food is lovely. They bring me the food, and I eat the food. All of the food. And I eat all day. Weight gain will not be a problem. Dad wants me to join him in Mumbai. There's nothing for me here in Casablanca. An empty apartment, painful memories, I can't stay here. But live with Dad, after all the things? As for my memories, not a whole lot of those, not since before the whole ordeal. But Dad filled in a few of the gaps when I woke up. Reza vanished. I went searching for him. I discovered the Wadi Corp Dream Machine project/conspiracy, the story Reza was chasing. I also found out that my mother was involved, except I didn't know she was my mother. Also, I didn't know my mother was alive. Also, she put me in a coma. Summary? Went off after investigative journalist ex-boyfriend on silly rescue mission. Discovered corporate plot to control people's dreams. Found out my father's been lying to me all my life and that my mother isn't dead. In short, I thwarted a global conspiracy and in return, Mummy Dearest injected me with an experimental drug. It's a sordid story. I could probably sell it for a billion yuan. New yuan. I can never pronounce that currency. But hey, bonus, I saved the world. Made some tasty lemonade from those pesky lemons. No, following Dad to Mumbai is not an option. I'll have to do this on my own now. Without Dad, without a safety net, without memories. I'm Zoe Castillo. Awake, alive, amnesiac. April 10th. Dear Diary, etc. 1 week. On my feet and feeling fine. Scary how quickly you can get over being in a coma for a year with the help of modern science. I barely have bed sores. So what now? Reza and I are talking about getting together again, and I've been thinking. He's living in Europolis. I'm rootless. No roots. I can go anywhere. It doesn't matter. I'm starting a new life. I get to pick where to begin. Yes, relationship. I work fast. Is this a good thing? It feels like it could be. Reza visited me almost every day when I was sick. He never stopped talking to me. He was the first thing I saw when I woke up. Okay, yes, so we broke up because it wasn't working, but that was before. This is after, and I'm different. We both are. We both turned a page, begun a new chapter. It is a good thing. I think I will join Reza in Europolis. Why not? It'll be an adventure. April 14th. I've decided to cut off contact with Dad. At least for now. This may turn out to be a bad idea, but I'm angry and disappointed. I can't forgive him for keeping so many secrets from me for so many years. Telling me my mother was dead when she so clearly wasn't, even if she was an evil bitch, and she is, and even if she ended up trying to kill me, and she did, that's not something you do to your only child. You don't lie. Not about that shit. I hope these feelings will pass. Or maybe hope isn't the right word. I'll keep an open mind. But for now, and for the foreseeable future, he will not be a part of my life. My life right now is all about getting back on my feet. Emotionally, I'm walking just fine. And moving to Europolis to live with Reza. That's enough for now. April 17th. Tomorrow. Tomorrow, bye-bye Casablanca. Hello, Europolis. Europolis? That's so European. I've barely been to Europe. Not a huge fan. Rampant poverty, crime, pollution, awful food, and yet that's where I'm going. Europolis. Prague District. Propast. That was an easy choice, since that's where Reza is working. Yes, he's still with the hand that feeds. Still an investigative journalist. Still taking that whole saving the world thing seriously. I love him. I still don't know what I'll be doing once I get to Europolis, aside from playing house with Reza. When I woke up, I knew I didn't want to go back to school to continue my bioengineering degree. It was crystal clear to me, like I'd had that whole argument in my head while I was in the coma and it was settled. That's fine. I'm not going to fight it. I'm just curious why my mind was set. It was odd. And so this part here is based on our decision that we wanted to try something new when we woke up. If you choose the familiar path, then Zoe will go back into bioengineering, which was her original major at university. But in this case, as she's already mentioned to Dr. Roman, she's gone from bioengineering into artificial intelligence. Also, you'll notice here that says the company, the publication, the media company that Reza works for is called The Hand That Feeds. Now, I could have sworn that in the previous game it was called The Hand That Bites. So I don't know if Ragnar changed his mind or he forgot and made it slightly different for this time around, because I don't think they ever mentioned the company, the paper, as The Hand That Bites in this whole game. They call it The Hand That Feeds. So I have no idea why they made that change. It's not a big deal, really, because it's basically still the same company that Reza was working for in Dreamfall. But for some reason, the name seems different, unless I'm remembering it wrong. All right, April 22nd. Iris, capital letters, please. I hate Europolis. Thank you. Back to lowercase. 5 reasons I hate Europolis. There's no sun. None. It's always raining. Always. There's no vegetation. No trees, no plants, no grass. None. They claim to speak English, but it's littered with slang words like maus and boule. I don't understand half of what they're saying. Did I mention there's no sun? Fuck this. But oh, it's fantastic and I love it. Zoe, contradictions, you are full of them. I'm starting a new chapter. I'm putting the past behind me. I'm growing up. I'm no longer defined by who I was or what I did or didn't do before the coma. That's why I love it. We've already found a place super close to Reza's office, and we're moving in on Monday or Tuesday. Of course, we haven't actually seen the place outside of the simulation, but I'm sure it's perfect. It can be a hellhole, and it'll still be perfect. It doesn't matter how I feel about Europolis or about the apartment or about not having a job or about being shit scared, because I'm here now, and this is the beginning of a new story for me. So, yeah, that's something to note, is the entire time we're out here, we will never see a real sun, and it seems to be maybe not always raining, but quite often raining. And in case you're not a really big fan of the story, or it's just been a while since you've played the earlier ones, in this version of the 23rd century world, basically a lot of places that would be considered the developed world or the first world in our modern days are currently undergoing a lot of stagnation. So Central Eastern Europe, Britain, the United States, all seem to be, if not in decline, seem to be in a lot of internal struggle and strife. And while places like Central Europe seem to have united into Europolis, places like the U.S. have apparently broken up into city-states and mega-corporation holdings. Whereas the areas such as North Africa, which is where Casablanca is, India and China, seem to be doing fairly well at this point in history. All right, Monday, April 24th. I started therapy today. Dr. Roman Zelenka, psychotherapist. Good head of hair, dorky suit. Reza found him. He came recommended from someone at the hand. He's nice. I like him. There is chemistry. I can talk to him. He didn't push me or any of my very large buttons. Of course, it's all therapist smoke and mirrors, but I don't mind. If I don't see the strings being pulled, I don't care. Also, it's a 5-minute walk from home. Convenient. On that note, I do need to start working out. The food is pretty awesome here in ProPast. I'm still not quite sure what therapy is going to do. Help me remember? I do want to remember. How much and how fast, I don't know yet. I'll take things as they come, I guess. I'm adaptable. Adaptable Zoe. Tomorrow I start looking around for something locally. A job where I can use at least a few of my skills, or my head. Failing that, my body, and no, that doesn't sound right at all. I'd prefer something in tech, but I'm not picky. Whatever comes my way, I'll manage. Again, this is something that when you tell Dr. Roman you want to remember, you get this statement, as opposed to her saying that she's not sure she wants to remember. Okay. Next up. April 27th. So here are 3 facts about our tiny flat at the... I forget how to pronounce this. Sun and Shine? Sun and Shine? I'm going to say that for now. Does that just mean sunshine? Not in English, some other European language? Maybe. Plaza Terraces. It's tiny. It's the size of my bedroom in Casablanca, if you didn't include the balcony. It smells weird. The window looks straight into a brick wall with neon signs on it. But I love it. We have our own place. I couldn't wish for anything more. I feel liberated. I feel like myself again. Well, sort of. A forgetful amnesiac self. There we go. Half Zoe, but a better half. Similar to the previous game, Zoe tends to have her ups and downs emotionally. If you haven't noticed already. April 30th. Project Find a Friend or 5 has begun. It sounds so desperate, but I'm going to give it a shot. I'm going to try and build a life for myself here, and part of that is having friends, right? The lady with the food cart outside Dr. Zelenka's office is one of my projects. She's really weird and a bit too intense, but I like her. Nella, was it? Yes, Nella. She's on my list of candidates, friends candidates. If anyone ever finds out about this list, I will have to kill them. Sully's on the list too. Sully's a friend, but he's also Rez's best friend, so I can't hijack him and make him my best friend. Also, I'm starting to think that Sully might have the teeniest crush on me. He's sweet, though. A true mensch. Well, that was easy. I have a job, I think. I was in the Chinese market, what they call the bricks, because... bricks? Browsing for tea, when my iris popped up with a notification about a job posting just a few blocks away. Training neural engineer wanted, ASAP. Unreasonably long hours, shit pay. Contact Mira at the Pandemonium. I don't know, I found that intriguing. The place, Pandemonium, looks shady from the outside and even shadier on the inside, and Mira turned out to be incredibly offensive. But something about her reminded me of my friend Liv. Also, the job sounds interesting. It's a trainee position, and I'll have to do a ton of non-neuroprogramming stuff like deliveries and bot assembly, but I think I'll learn a lot. And it's a complete left turn for me, something completely different, which is good. At the same time, it's also like I'm following in Olivia DelMarco's footsteps, honoring her memory. She was always trying to teach me, and she kept asking me to start working for her. Of course, back then, I lacked the motivation and drive, but now I want to learn. I want to do something with my life. I don't know if this is it, but it's something. We'll see where it goes. Mira didn't really confirm whether I got the job or not, but she also said stop by at 9 o'clock tomorrow, so... yes? We'll see how that plays out, I guess. Her partner, Wit, didn't say a word when I was there, and Mira kept insulting him, but it didn't look like it bothered him at all. He seems like a gentle giant, but is he mute? He didn't even look at me once. I'm not sure I get him yet. He is huge, though. Massive. A mountain. June 15th. I knew I wouldn't be able to keep updating my journal on a regular basis. I'm so predictable. And busy. Busy me. Busy, busy bee. So, an update. Yoga for my mind. An exercise in memory. Here goes. Your opera is growing on me. Okay, yes, the flat is awful. The ventilation system rarely works. It's hot, and it smells weird. There's no sunlight, and people talk funny. But I like the energy. I like the diversity. Casablanca was like London. Beautiful, safe, prosperous. All shiny metal and glass and polished stone, but never particularly exciting. It's exciting here. And there's history in these streets. Filthy, stinky, crumbling, fading history, but history. There are art galleries and cinemas and 1,000,000,000 food carts. I had a pierogi for lunch and it was delicious. Sure, there are seedy sex clubs, illegal dream emporiums, and people urinating on the streets. But at least it's genuine urination. Urination with gusto. I like my job. Weird, I know. I'm not using my education at all, and I'm starting on the floor, below the floor. in the sub-sub-basement. But that's sort of refreshing, liberating. I'm learning a lot. I feel like I'm actually evolving. Maybe in 6 months, a year, I can use my newfound skills to get a good job. But for now, I like this. I've gone political. So that's pretty weird, I guess. When did Zoe ever care about politics? I hear people say inside their heads, which means I can also read minds now. Awesome. But I do. But I both do and don't. Let me explain. Dear Diary, I'm now volunteering for a political campaign. I was browsing the wire, looking for things to do locally, and there it was. An ad for a voluntary position assisting the Leia Uminska campaign. Uminska is the mayoral candidate for Unity, the Europolitan Social Democratic Party. Hey, I thought, that's a thing to do which could also be rewarding and interesting. I read up on Unity's agenda and Uminska's track record, figured that they were probably the party I'd vote for if I voted, which I haven't, and sent in my application. The next day, I met Baruti. Baruti is great. More about him later. And 30 minutes later, I was a volunteer with a mission. I was political. So why? It's like waking from a slumber, I guess, or hey, maybe a coma. Before all the things, I lived in a protected bubble. I was spoiled, I was bored, I was aimless. I didn't care. But going through what I went through, losing everything and everyone, moving to a new city, it's given me perspective, if nothing else. And even if I'm still not a very political person, I do see the need for change to happen, here, everywhere. Also, meeting Baruti and seeing his engagement and passion, that's infectious. It must be amazing to care as much as he does, to sacrifice and work hard to achieve something for the greater good. I want that. I want to be able to feel that way. And the Social Democrats seem like the only ones who won't do any more harm to Europolis. How's that for idealism? Also, I'm wondering if the fact that, again, Zoe has consciously, at least, she's forgotten everything that happened in her previous adventure in the last game. But if the Vagabond thinks that she can eventually, if she tries, that she can remember it, it may be that that old self is still down there somewhere in her subconscious. So the idea of doing something heroic, of sacrificing for the greater good, even if she doesn't remember being that way anymore consciously, I'm wondering if something subconsciously has kind of driven her to do what she can to, again, kind of fulfill that heroic drive. All right, as for Project Find a Friend, I am not doing a very good job. Here are my candidates. Nella, of Nella Bites. Food cart lady. Marxist. Firecracker. Very loud and energetic. Better in small doses. I can tolerate having lunch with her and maybe watching an old movie. Not a sleepover or a day of shopping. Or a night of drinking. Sully. Love Sully. Sully is the best. But he's Rez's friend, and he likes me a teeny bit too much for us to just hang out on our own without it feeling maybe a teensy bit awkward. He's still awesome. Best guy. Baruti, campaign manager guy. Yeah, maybe? He makes me smile, and I have a lot of fun working with him, for him. But he's my boss, and we're very different. We can be friendly. We can have drinks and talk about the campaign or Europolis or food, but that's as far as it goes. Mira? Wit? Yeah, no. Reza? This is a depressing list. Alright, two more entries. July 23rd? I can't believe it's not sand. I read they used imported space rocks that are pulverized, processed, exposed to radiation to, hey, irony, remove radiation, and then they use it to make fake beaches. Why not just use sand? Or earth rocks? Are space rocks so much better than earth rocks? Anyway, we're not in Europolis anymore, Toto. Triste is exactly how I imagine Triste 2 would be like. Filled with Europoliticians escaping the smog and fog and heat and rain and pollution in order to risk skin cancer on fake beaches while eating food that's a lot worse than the food in Propast in hotels made of plastic polymers. Also, swimming is out of the question. You really need to wear a hazmat suit to go swimming in the Mediterranean these days. This is a far cry from the pristine beaches of Camps Bay or Engor, or even Zanzibar. And now I miss Africa. But this trip wasn't about all that. It was about getting away and being together and strengthening our relationship. It's been a bit rocky lately. It's been tough on Reza to have me in his space, and tough on me to jump straight from a year-long coma to relationship. Tough all around. There have been moments when I thought, this was a good choice? Or was this a good choice? Did I really think it through? Can I deal with the consequences? So yeah, we needed this. We need more of this. We're both so busy and preoccupied in ProPast that we sometimes get on each other's nerves. Here, we've been able to relax, find peace, and have lots and lots of awesome sex. I am still worried. I'm worried that we'll grow apart again. I'm worried that my instincts were right the first time around, that Rez is a good friend more than he is a partner. I'm worried, but I'll leave the worrying now for another day while I focus on soaking up the last few rays of wonderful sun. Also, can't complain about the sex. Sunday night, an update. It's really late, and I have to be up really early. Rez is in the shower, and I'm lying here in bed, staring up into the ceiling, thinking. It was such a hassle getting back into ProPast. There are eye checkpoints everywhere now, and you need to show papers just to move between sectors, which is insane. So we waited in line for almost an hour, and then we started arguing, and suddenly all the good vibes from the weekend vanished, and I felt like crying. It got better afterwards. We made up, but I can't help feel there's something off. Like we started down different paths, and right now those paths are parallel, but soon they'll diverge again. And then? Yeah, here's Reza now. I think I'm overreacting. I'm so tired and grumpy, and good night. And now, July 24th. I think this is about... Is this the same day? It's got to be close. It's either just before the current time, or it's about the same... during the same day, because... There's that 3 months again. 3 months in therapy. Still batshit crazy. Hello. I'm not complaining. The doc's doing a good job. Probably. My head's a mess. I've lost over a year of memories. But I'm getting better-ish. And I do want to remember. That's probably a step in the right direction, right? At least there's that. Anyway, I spent enough time in my head today. No more psychotherapy. Dear Diary. Let's move forward and focus on the present. All right. And I believe they give you a notification every time there's a new entry. I don't think it's necessarily every new thing that you do as Zoe, she reports, but I think I'll try to keep up with that just in case she has some extra insight that she doesn't say during the game proper. Here's a quick look at our gallery here. And again, we'll look at these as new entries come up. Zoe Castillo, 21, was raised in London and Casablanca by her father, Gabriel. She studied bioengineering at Cape Town University for 2 years before dropping out of school and moving back to Casablanca. 1 year ago, Zoe's ex-boyfriend, Reza Tamiz, went missing. Zoe discovered that Reza, a journalist, had been investigating a story about a new entertainment device created by Wadi Corp. The dream machine was designed to produce lucid dreams, but was being used covertly to harvest users' memories. Zoe helped unravel the conspiracy, delaying the release of the dream machine and exposing the conspirators. But she couldn't save herself. She was drugged by her mother, Helena Chang, who played a hitherto unknown role in the conspiracy, and left to die in her home in Casablanca. Zoe's been in a coma for over 9 months now, trapped in a hospital bed while simultaneously living a parallel existence in a place called the Storytime, a world of dreams. Here, using the powers granted to her as the dreamer, Zoe's capable of shaping people's dreams, helping those trapped in night terrors making their way back to waking. Okay, back, here we go. Wonkers gets his own entry. He's so cute. Wonkers is an autonomous robot toy manufactured by Wadi Corp. And Zoe's beloved childhood friend. Wonkers helped Zoe get through her previous adventure, but has been powered off since then. And we will see him again a little bit later. The Vagabond. The Vagabond is the mysterious warden of storytime, a world of dreams where all stories begin and end. Zoe has encountered the Vagabond on a few occasions, but she still knows little about him. He appears to know more than he's willing to tell Zoe, and he may have less control over this dreaming realm than she first thought. You'll notice that he also has tattooing, just like Zoe did. So it makes me wonder whether he also used to be some kind of mortal who was also a dreamer and ended up getting permanently stuck in the story time. Here's Warden Murren. The Warden of Friar's Keep is a native Northlander and Markurian who has willingly collaborated with the Azadi occupiers to convert the city Gaul into a political prison, housing dissenters and rebels. Warden Murren has embraced the foreigners and their rigid military order with near sadistic enthusiasm, though he has little patience for their spiritual beliefs. Murren's prized prisoner is Kian Alvani, a high-ranking Azadi assassin who betrayed his own people and was sentenced to death for his crimes. The man sure does love bureaucracy. Commander Vaman. Vaman is an Azadi military commander, head of the secret police in Markuria, the emissary's most trusted man, and her illicit lover. When the apostle Kian Alvani first arrived in Markuria, Vaman was ordered by the emissary, Sister Saya, to keep an eye on him, and when Kian traveled to the Swamp City to meet the rebel leader, April Ryan, Vaman had him followed. Kian's arrest was the culmination of a lifetime of jealousy. Vaman wants nothing more than to see Kian dead. The two men have history, and their rivalry is personal. Vaman and Saya are secretly plotting to increase their power over Markuria. With command over the secret police and the troops stationed in the city, Vaman has an iron grip on Markuria, and the hated resistance is finally in his sights. With their imminent defeat, nothing will stand in his way. Is Kian himself? Kian Alvani was once the Azadi apostle, serving the goddess as a holy assassin. A man of unwavering faith, Kian did what the Six and their priestesses commanded him to do without question, without doubt. A year ago, called upon the Six in Sadir, capital of Azadir, Kian received an important mission, to travel to Markuria, capital of the Northlands, to find and assassinate the leader of the Resistance of Magicals. During the course of this mission, Kian's faith was challenged. Upon meeting the rebel leader, April Ryan, he began questioning his superiors and their occupation of Markuria, and whether or not he truly served the word of the goddess. Kian's refusal to assassinate April led to his imprisonment and death sentence. Locked up in Friar's Keep for almost a year now, Kian is a man at a crossroads, a man without a people and in the midst of a crisis of faith. To move forward, Kian has to remake himself, stand up against the very people he once trusted implicitly, and find his own way in the world for the first time in 20 years. Rest in peace, Captain Balsay. Captain Balsay Bakken is a relatively recent convert to the rebel cause. Before meeting April Ryan, the deceased leader of the resistance, Bakken profited from the Azadi occupation, lending them the use of his ship. In return, the Azadi turned a blind eye to his small-time smuggling operation. Bakken's turning point came after meeting April. Her convictions changed his perspective. Using his relationship with the Azadi as cover, he began smuggling arms, food, and medicine to the rebels in Markuria, and he even helped establish and supply the rebel outpost in Myria, the Swamp City. And last but not least for now is Sister Saya. Sister Saya is the Azadi emissary to the Northlands. As stewardess of Markuria and administrator of the Engine Project, she's the youngest priestess to ever rise so fast and far, and there are whispers that she may someday become a mother. Putting her status and life at risk, however, is her illicit relationship with Commander Vaman and her ambition to rise above the role of emissary, to establish a new Azadi seat of power in the Northlands. The two lovers are plotting to cement their control over Mercuria and use the engine to serve their own ambitions. Saya answers to the Six, the child empresses of the Azadi Empire, as well as the mysterious Prophet, architect of the engine. We haven't seen much of the engine yet. We actually did see small little parts of it in the previous game, but it wasn't recognized as being part of what they call the engine here. But we're going to find out more about that later. And I believe that the reason that her status is at risk is that I believe the sisters and the mothers are not supposed to engage in romantic relations with men. I think that's forbidden by the religion. I could be wrong on that, but I think that's the case. The Azadi are very, very matriarchal when it comes to political power. And rather unlike the Northlanders, such as Warden Murren, who seem to have a sexist attitude towards women. It's a mess all around over in Arcadia. All right, let's have a look at Dr. Roman, and then we'll talk to him.
Dr. Zelenka. Roman. Dr. Roman? Doc? I don't even know what to call him anymore. The doc's been good for me, I think. And good to me. I do need someone to talk to about things. All the things. Everything. And he is sort of cute, but... Oh, no. No, that's not a good thought. That's a bad thought. Ugh. Oh, authority figure. So cliché, Zoe. Doctor... Roman?
Yes.
Maybe I shouldn't be bothering him. He probably has another appointment right away. Do you have an appointment now?
No, I prefer some space between sessions. I don't like to rush. I prefer to sit and take notes afterwards.
So, what are you writing?
Well, just notes about what we talked about today. It's a way for me to remember and process our conversation.
Makes sense.
To be absolutely honest, I don't have another appointment for several hours. I like keeping my Mondays light.
Oh. Yeah, we could start later if you'd prefer.
No, this gets me out of bed in the morning. Without it, I'd just sleep in.
I don't know Dr. Zelenka, Roman, very well at all. I don't even know where he's from originally. How long have you practiced in Europolis?
Oh, 4 years? No, 5. I graduated from Krakow in 2214 and worked 2 years in the Warsaw district before moving to Berlin.
And Propast?
I set up this practice 7 months ago.
Are you from the Prague district?
I'm originally from Poznan. My parents are of Polish descent. Not that that matters anymore. European is European. Yeah, you wouldn't know it talking to my father, though. He is a traditional nationalist. I think he secretly wishes for the downfall of Europolis and a return to the independent nation-states. Was there anything else?
Roman seems like an interesting person, and we've never really talked about anything other than me. This could be a good time to start, talking. I don't know what I'm doing. Should I be doing this? I don't know.
I don't think a small talk would be harmful.
So... what do you get up to when you're not, you know, this?
Oh, I don't know.
I'm sorry if this is getting too personal.
No. I was just trying to think about how to answer that. I don't really do things. When I'm not working, I think about work. Or I write about work, or I read about work.
Oh. And how does your wife feel about that?
I'm not married. I live by myself. Which has advantages and disadvantages. Mostly in my case, disadvantages. I'm not good at taking care of myself.
Really? Huh. So, Roman is single and spends too much time by himself. He could really do with a social life. You should get out more. Think about something other than work.
What did you have in mind?
I'm not the best person to ask. I'm, a homebody.
Sounds like we both should get out more.
We should. I mean, you should, and so should I, also.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. I'm not quite sure where this conversation is going. It's very confusing. I should probably just cut it short, but I'm also curious. Cat, meet curiosity. Hello, curiosity. Ah. So,
you could show me what I'm missing out on sometime.
Oh, yeah, I can do that. That is a thing I can do.
Of course, it would have to wait until we're done with your therapy. You're a patient, and that's, you know.
Right. Yes. Of course. That line of patient and doctor, that line.
Yes. Good. I'll look forward to that. I should finish, noting these notes before, you know, I forget everything we talked about.
Noted? No, that would be a bad thing, really.
Zoe's in quite a mess. We saw in her journal that she thinks that Dr. Roman is kind of cute. At the same time, she says that she loves Reza. So it just seems like she's in a big mess right now.
Oh, sorry. I didn't know you were still here.
I feel horrible about the direction this conversation's been taking. I'm not sure what I was thinking. Flirting with my therapist. Yeah, you should come out with Reza and me sometime.
With the... Oh, yes, of course, sometime. After we've concluded your therapy, of course. I don't mix my professional and private lives.
That's not a good mix. That's like gummy bears and potassium chlorate. Keep them apart.
Right. Well, I should finish writing these notes before I forget everything we talked about.
Of course. Good idea. That's... Yeah. Okay.
I mean, you can choose not to tell Dr. Roman that Zoe is in a relationship with Reza at the moment. I've seen different players think that Zoe should just dump Reza and just go with Dr. Roman. I know some players that think that it's not appropriate at all and she should stay with Reza. I know some players who just think they should get rid of both of them and just let Zoe figure out things on her own. I can see arguments all the way around.
Oh, sorry. I didn't know you were still here.
My next appointment with Dr. Roman is in my calendar, but I might as well double check while I'm here. When's our next session again?
Next Monday. At, let me check. Next Monday at 9. Is that still okay?
That's fine. Thank you. I think I might have outstayed my welcome. See you next week.
Take care, Zoe.
Okay, I think we're finally apt to go out the door here.